trending news. I will vote yes for Biafran in a hypothetical referendum, says Senator Abaribe. The minority leader in the Nigerian state, Mr. Einaya Abaribe, has said that in a hypothetical referendum for Biafran, he would vote for them. He made the declaration in an interview with the Rufto Okonkwo of Okroko Post TV. I will vote for us to actually be on our own, he said. I think we are being dragged down by all the different things that weigh Nigerians down. The senator representing Abia State constituency in the state, however, warned that the Nigerian constitution does not have a provision for a referendum, which means that if you want a referendum, you have to go outside the constitution to continue, he declared. Jettisoning the 1999 constitution requires having a meeting of all the different groups in Nigeria and having them agree to set that constitution aside and have a conference to agree on a new thing. He said that those who are benefiting from the current structure will always ignore that suggestion. Mr. Abaribe challenged different Biafran groups to come together under one umbrella to avoid dissipating energy needed to focus and get to a particular position. While we look for getting out of Nigeria, we should also, at this time, use the resources that we have to be able to make our homeland a better place for us, he insisted. Because if we are not doing anything with the resources that we already have, what is the guarantee that going into Biafran will give us a better frame of mind? On the issue of Fulani herdsmen attacking communities across the south and in the influx of northern youths to the south, the Senator Abaribe acknowledged that elected officials from the east are worried about some of the young people coming in from outside Nigeria. They don't speak regular Hausa, they don't speak English, they don't speak Pidgin, he said. Some of them just speak French, some speak other languages, and those are the ones that we are very, very bothered about, because we think that these people may just be people who are coming as sleeper cells and can be activated anytime. The leader of the People's Democratic Party in the Senate said that it would be good for people in the East to come together and have one response to the situation. He suggested that it would be better for the East to respond by using the tools available to elected chief executives in government houses across the region. What we don't want is a situation where you take your own personal action and it is tagged something else, Mr. Abaribe said. The type of stigmatization that leads to IPOP and all that will also apply it. We don't go through the formal network that the governors will have to institute. It will be seen as something else. And when you now have a clash with the police and army, of course, we know what follows. He remembered and reminded his constituents that everything that happens in the Southeast is regarded as a different thing entirely. He warned that we do really want to solve a problem, not to create another problem while solving one. When pushed on why everything that happens in the East should be regarded differently, the former deputy governor of Abia State told Ikok Post TV's Rodo Okonkwo that the civil war has not ended in some people's mind in Nigeria, that the government in power seems to have that mindset that whatever they do, they are going saraka, that a favor to us, that is not our rights, that we are just giving you what you don't deserve. He said that the mindset of people in the corridors of power in Nigeria is that nobody elected them, and as such, they owe the people nothing and could not be held accountable. Sorry to say, in the North, there is a fordolastic mindset in which you have people up there and the rest of the people on the ground, and whatever they do for them, they are just doing them to favor, and when they extend it to the rest of us in the South and see our creation, they cannot understand it. Mr. Aberiwe urged young people to get involved in the political process, to put it on elected officials, to compel them to do the right thing. When reminded that when young people get involved, they are killed by security agencies, he said, getting involved demands sacrifices. Sometimes it is easier to do it from the cozy rooms in front of your laptop than to be on the streets and march. The former lecturers at Edo State University said that the alternative to agitation, despite the risk involved, was to bad people to continue to do the wrong things all the time. We don't avoid war because we could be killed, he said, deploying an Igbo proverb. We just have to continue to do what we need to do in terms of agitation, because if we don't, ultimately, bad people will continue to do wrong things and we will not be aware of it. Thank you, viewers, for listening to this news. Viewers, I want to say one or two words about this news. The Almighty God will strengthen all Biafrans worldwide and made Biafran a nation sooner or later. God bless you. God bless Aberibe for everything he said about Biafran's agitation. He's indeed a good leader. Biafra will eventually emerge and someone as you fight the throne of honor. More power to his elbow. With these words of encouragement given by Aberibe to the Igbos and to the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, I'm very much sure that those who wish Biafra, who is praying and planning for Biafran's downfall, will be the one to go down. Because Biafran, this year, will gain its republic. They will definitely gain their republic, no matter what. For years now, many of us, we were occupying seats in the House in the house of nobody. If we ever like, we talk about future as of the Igbos. Better be executed or better execute and publicize than to die in the hands of those adopters, those Boko Harams and Fulanis. Some Igbos never want to support Biafran agitation. They never wanted to support Nnamdi Kanu. All they do is to criticize and support and come and talk ill about Nnamdi Kanu. They join hands, the Awusas, some Igbos, Fulanis, and some Yorubas. A plan to destroy Nnamdi Kanu so that the struggle of Biafran will no longer exist anymore. But it will never succeed. They will never succeed. What God has laid hand on, nobody can separate it. That is it. So viewers, what is your take on this news? Your comments, as I've given mine, is also needed. Don't hesitate to drop them below the comment box. Click on the subscribe button as well as the bell button to receive updates whenever I publish new videos. And don't forget, share and like this news as well. Thank you.